Hi, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. In our last video, we built a gRPC service from scratch using .NET 8, and we explored the basics of setting up high-speed, reliable APIs. If you haven't checked that out yet, I highly recommend starting there to get up to speed. In this video, we are taking it to the next level. Many applications rely on standard RESTful APIs to interact with HTTP methods like post, get, update, and delete if you want to perform your CRUD operation. So today, I'll show you how you can convert your gRPC service into a RESTful API. This way, you will get the best of both worlds, a gRPC service that is high performance for internal calls and a RESTful API that is accessible for broader use across different clients. So if you are excited to make your gRPC service even more versatile, please like the video, subscribe, and let's dive right in it. This is a project that we started, and you can see that we created a solution. We chose our gRPC template, and now in that we did just few things to make this work. All that we did was to create our proto file for our product, and there's like the interface. We have our details and our interface that we created. Aside from that, you know, in .NET world, when you create an interface, definitely going to create implementation. We did same as a service in the product service, and we're able to perform the tasks that you want to do as soon as that specific interface is being called. That is all. After that, we added a service that we created, we register that, and it exposes it. This is quite simple. So working with gRPC is quite simple. Now let's see, we have our CRUD operation or our CRUD interface in our protos here. So this is what we're going to be using to communicate between the client and on the server. We have them specified in the service. Now how do we enable this in a RESTful API? Normally we know front end needs to post, to get, to delete, to update. How can this be possible? Let's see. So first of all, we need to install some two packages. That is what you're going to be using. You know, in making your RESTful API, there are so many ways of doing it. One is using JsonTranscoding, and that is what I'm going to talk about in this video. First of all, in order for us to use that, we need to install that package, JsonTranscoding, and we need to install gRPC.tools. Let's get them installed. So these are the packages that you need to install: Microsoft.ASP.NET Core, .gRPC.JsonTranscoding, and also gRPC.tools. Now get these packages installed. So now if I go to my dependencies and check my packages, I'm going to see these packages there when they are restored. Let's wait to see. And yes, of course, you can see we have them installed in here. Now the next thing that we're going to do here is we need to add a proto file for HTTP and also an annotation. Now we can get them from this link. So when you open your browser, you can go to GitHub. I'll put them in the video description. So we need this an http.proto, and also we need the annotations.proto, and that is a link that you can go in for github.com. You have Google APIs, you have blog master Google APIs, api/annotations.proto, and that is what you can even search it through the Google search, and you're going to have access. Just search for annotations.proto and you can get this link, and I'm getting to it. So we're going to copy this, and we're also going to copy this http.proto. We need two files here in order to enable our RESTful API endpoint in this gRPC service. So let's grab the first one. Let's copy this. Let's go to your solution. Now in your project, we want to create folder. We want to make sure that we have the same link as specified in here, Google API, and then we have our proto file. So let's rename this to Google. Let's add another folder in it. APIs, and then let's go and create proto bar file. So we go to add new item, then let's search for proto. So we need protocol buffer file, that is proto buff. So let's make sure this is HTTP. You know what we copied, let's look at it well. We copied annotation, so this should be annotations. So we have annotations.proto file, and in here, after it gets created, we're going to paste what we have, so we can just copy this. And now let's paste this. We don't need to go through this. It's a file that we need to add to enable us to work with the HTTP method. Okay, so now we have annotations over here copied and pasted. Now when you check again, we also need the HTTP. So we go to the HTTP, that is an HTTP.proto. So let's also grab this. And we also paste it here. So we also have the HTTP in there. So these are the two files that we need to enable that. Now, after we are done with this, we need to go to the product service. And that is the proto file, the product.proto in the proto folder. And in there, we're going to expose this endpoint. So let's do it. So that is what we need to do. Now check it up. We have this going to be our get product by ID. So this is going to be our route. That HTTP method here, or the verb here, is get. And then we need a product and the ID. This ID is going to be the parameter we're going to be supplied. Now let's check the list product. It is get and it is slash product. So this is going to be the route. So it looks like the same way that you're going to expose your endpoint in your API. And then we have this is post method, we have our put method, and that is going to be the delete. So with the update and uncreate, you know, it's going to accept a payload. So that's going to be the body. We want to accept everything in there, and that is what we need to do. So this is quite simple, just two lines. You can configure your gRPC service into a RESTful API. Good. Now after we are done with this, we need to import. You know, we are using this data annotation, so we need to import that file from the link that we created. You can see we created from Google API and then annotation.proto. So we need to import it in here. So let's do that. So after importing this, the next thing again that we need to do is to add JSON transcoding service. So we can do that from your program file. So you can see from here we are adding gRPC service already. So dot add JSON transcoding, let's do that. Okay, now that we are done with this, we need to go in and I'll make HTTP one accessible, which is the RESTful API. So when you go to your line settings, check it out from here. Oh, that is a app setting.json. you can see from the Kestrel server, it's having the default endpoint of HTTP 2. That is the gRPC. Now you want to include one so that you can have access to this RESTful API endpoint. So you want to clear this, then say HTTP 2, then end. Let's even make it HTTP 1, then end HTTP 2. So you want our gRPC service to also work whilst we have the API, RESTful API also work. So we want to have both service running. So if you want to call this gRPC service internally, we can do it. Or if you want to expose it, the endpoint, so front end can make request, it can also work. So within each, it is taking for front end making a request or RESTful API, it is using the HTTP 1. And for internal service call, it's going to be using this HTTP 2. So we want to make them both supported. Great. So now that we have this, what is left again for us to do is to run this application and check it out. So you can see that from our console, we're saying that the endpoint is configured to use HTTP 1 and HTTP 2, but TLS is not enabled. Yeah, we'll do that. Okay, so now our endpoint supports two HTTP, that is a 1 and a 2. Let's make sure we have a postman because we don't have any swagger, so we can test our endpoint. So we need postman or something like that to do it. Now in our postman, we want to test the two services, right? So the first one is going to be the gRPC. So let's click on this new. Then let's check if our gRPC is still working. Let's wait. Now in here, let's go and import the proto file. And that is our proto.proto. So we choose this. And we can go to import. And you can see as soon as you are done with that, if I click on this, we're going to have our endpoint here, right? Now let's go in there and create something. So we'll click on this message and now let's do it. Okay, so this is our message, that's our body, and this should correspond with the proto or our DTO that we created. When you check our proto.proto, we have the name, description, and price. And when you check the create, it takes in name, description, and price. So we must make sure that we have same as what we set up there. After we are done with that, let's get the endpoint here. So let's go to our console. We can work with HTTP. So let's grab this local host. Then in there, paste it, and now enable TLS. And now click on invoke. We are creating product. So we should get a success response if this works. And of course, it worked. So you see, we have it. Now let's make another one. So we make it as 2. And that is a description of 2. We can add one more. Invoke this, and this should also work. Good, we have it. Let's add one more to 3. Then we can say product 3. Now let's invoke this. And this is also working. So we can test the other endpoint to see get list product. Check it up. We have all the 3 products that we added. We have them working, right? And now we are using this gRPC proto file to make this call. Now, out of in case you want to have our HTTP call, let's see. So click on new, and now here we're going to choose an HTTP. No more gRPC. Now with HTTP, we're going to copy our link. So let's go and grab our link from here. Let's paste it. This is get. And here we're going to say it is product. The controller name here is product. If I click on send, I should get the same product response. You can see we have it. Now I can also make get it by 1. So by specifying only 1, make a send, and I should get that specific product. You see, I have it here. Now if I want to update, I'll need to provide with a post. Then maybe I can go to the first one, the message body, grab this, and I go back to the HTTP, and then here I go to the body, then choose raw, and I'm come and choose JSON. Let's paste this. Let's specify the ID. The ID is 1, and you want to say product 1 updated. Product 1 updated. We can also say that product 1 description. We can also update this as well. Let's reduce the price. Okay, now click on send. We're making, okay, so this should be put. So let's make it as put, and we have it, right? Let's see, execute this, and this should work now. Good, it's working. Now we can go out there, and I'll make get product one, and I'll check it up. You can see we have it updated. We can also get the list from get a product list, and we have the product one updated. So in this simple terms, we've seen how we can convert our gRPC service into RESTful API. Stay tuned for the next one where we integrate a lot of features in this. If you like this, don't forget to subscribe and also hit on the notification button to receive update as soon as I upload new one. Stick around for the next video on gRPC.